Hey, what's up everybody? Got another DIY project for you. In this video, we'll show you how to build a portable HDMI monitor. This is a pretty cool project, great for cameras, computers, and of course, the Raspberry Pi. Now, you'll only need a few parts to build this project, and it actually won't cost you a premium. The HDMI backpack is a plug-and-play monitor, and it can be powered through USB. But to make this portable, we'll use a PowerBoost 1000C and a 2500 milliamp LiPo battery. The PowerBoost will actually convert the 3.7 volts from the battery into 5 volts to properly power the monitor. We'll use a slide switch to toggle the power, and a bonus awesome feature, you can actually recharge the battery using micro USB. So it's got a charging circuit built in. To keep everything together, we designed an enclosure for 3D printing. We'll mount the display to the standoffs and optimize the overhang so we can print with no support material. You can download the CAD files and customize the design to fit your project. To print these parts, your 3D printer will need a big enough build plate. You can print the two-piece enclosure in your favorite filament, and it'll only take about 4 hours to print. So while we do that, let's go ahead and get started on the circuit. Let's take the slide switch and bend the leads. That way we can easily fit it inside the enclosure later. I recommend checking out the guide on the Adafruit Learning System. We put together a circuit diagram so you can follow along and build this project. Next up, we'll insert the wired slide switch through the enclosure. We'll go ahead and tin the pads on the display to make it easier to solder wires to ground at 5 volts. On the PowerBoost 1000C, we'll go ahead and solder the connections to ground at 5 volts. Next, connect the wires from the slide switch to enable and ground. This will let you safely turn the display on or off. Now we can mount the PowerBoost to the standoffs on the cover with machine screws. We can get the display mounted to the enclosure using another set of 440 machine screws. The battery connects to the JSD port and you can attach it to the inside of the cover using a piece of gaffer's tape, and that'll keep it in place. To cover up the enclosure, we'll fasten another set of machine screws to the corners. Okay, now we can remove the protective film from the screen. We actually left it on there this whole time so we don't scratch the screen. And last but not least, we can install a 1/4-20 thread insert. This will allow you to mount the display to any standard tripod. We actually put two here so you can mount it in either portrait or landscape. And for recording this video, we use shoe mounts to attach to the DSLR. Most cameras have a standard hot shoe adapter, so you can easily attach your monitor to the top of any camera. So you can use this display to monitor your video footage or even help you compose that shot if you're doing photography. You can also use it as a second screen to display your favorite stream. What would you use this monitor for? Tell us in the comments below. If you want to make a smaller display that uses your camera's LiPo battery, definitely check out this project over here. Thank you guys for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more 3D printing projects from Adafruit. We'll see you guys next week.